All right, we want to get to the final topic of the day, and this is really a good one. Let's end with Bitcoin getting beaten up in the last 2 days, dropping nearly 1,000. Jim, you and I were talking about this. So, I mean, every asset class is pretty much getting hammered here. What do you want to trade do with Bitcoin right now?
Well, I think once it broke that 6,000 level, I think that's tremendously significant. So I think it was trading with a 54 handle right now. If it trades 53.90, so just below 54 again, I think it's a spot to short it with a target of 49.90 on the downside. I think we were this close to getting a new handle in. I think they're not going to rest until they do. A stop placed back above 56.80. And again, this to me is everything psychologically has changed as soon as it went below 6,000. And you could see that in the trade. There was a lot of people who were waiting for that to print to dump it. And whatever we're going through, I don't think is over as far as the weakness in Bitcoin.
Okay, Brian, what do you think of that one?
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned the 6,000 level. That was very key. And, I still think we probably maybe retest and trade back up close to there before going maybe lower again. But here's what came out is basically the IMF was talking about that governments need to start to consider developing basically their own electric currency, allowing electric trading, electric wallet. You basically keep your own U.S. dollar or whatever, the euro, on your own wallet away from the banks. And that actually is going to take away from Bitcoin for sure. So when you look at that development, if that's something that more governments start to move towards, she talked about Sweden maybe moving in that way. If people more move towards that, that'll basically split it. Bitcoin will basically be a complete alternative currency you use. And then you'll also have the government fiat currencies done electronically. I think that's the world we're moving to. And if you're a bank, and you see this sort of movement, this is really going to hurt banks, because why do you keep your money on deposit? You don't need to. You actually can technically stuff the money underneath your pillow electronically on your own wallet.
All this sounds good to me in a situation where the markets are more stable and everything seems good. If everything goes to hell in a handbasket, I don't think, Jim, that I'm going to want to be a holder of Bitcoin.
I don't either. I think when you in your head go through like the hell in a handbasket thing, is Bitcoin the right thing to have? I'm not sure it is either. But there's something else that we've been talking about since Bitcoin 20,000, and that's when these headlines come out, they're never going to be that positive for Bitcoin. Governments don't want a decentralized currency. Government really wants centralized currencies. They're not going to embrace Bitcoin. They want everything going through their balance sheet and not somebody else's. So I think that that Bitcoin might be a vehicle, but I don't think it's ever going to be an investment.
All right, let's get the... All right, one last comment to Brian, and then we'll get the first quote.
No, I get the point of hell in the handbasket. Maybe it's not Bitcoin, but when you look at the alternative, if you're looking at gold or somewhere else.
We keep saying it, so let's just...
I know, right? Yeah. So to change that subject, it's not going to happen, I don't think. I think Bitcoin actually will be an alternative. It'll be something more efficiently used than something like gold and keeping gold bars stored somewhere or whatnot. That will be the alternative currency that people look to when you want to remove from fiat currency. The fiat currency is not going away anytime soon, but this will be the new alternative, I believe.